Good morning all. Now we will be discussing different bodies. These bodies are always important considering your exam. First is civet bodies. Civet bodies you will see in a dermatology condition. This is known as lichen planus. So you will see civet bodies in lichen planus. Second body is Mallory body. Mallory body you will be seeing in many liver diseases, especially alcohol induced diseases. So it is seen in alcoholic hepatitis and alcoholic cirrhosis. Councilman bodies are feature of acute viral hepatitis. So what are Councilman bodies? These are apoptotic hepatocytes which we will see in acute viral hepatitis. Russell bodies and Dutcher bodies, these are two bodies that we see in multiple myeloma. Russell bodies and Dutcher bodies are two bodies that you will see where in multiple myeloma. Examiner's favorite, Ashoff bodies or Ashoff cells. These Ashoff bodies are pathognomonic features for rheumatic fever. These are seen in rheumatic fever. Michaelis-Guttmann bodies are seen in a condition that is called malacoplakia. Malacoplakia. This is a disorder of urinary bladder. Then we have Verruquet bodies. These Verruquet bodies are seen in brain tumors. This is known as schwannoma is a tumor of Schwann cells. Here you will see Verruquet bodies. Always remember, this Verruquet bodies will show two pattern, and these patterns are named by Antony. So they are called Antony A pattern and Antony B pattern. Antony A pattern and Antony B pattern. Next is Karl-Exner bodies. These are seen in granulosa cell tumor. Karl-Exner bodies are seen in granulosa cell tumor. Schiller-Duval bodies are seen in yolk sac tumor. Another name of yolk sac tumor is endodermal sinus tumor. Yolk sac tumor or endodermal sinus tumor. Next is Hirano bodies. Hirano bodies are seen in brain. You will see Hirano bodies in Alzheimer dementia. Hirano bodies are present in Alzheimer disease or Alzheimer dementia. Next body is Lewy bodies. Lewy bodies are seen in Parkinson disease. Lewy bodies are seen in Parkinson disease. Pick bodies are seen in Pick's disease. Pick's bodies are seen in Pick's disease. Negri bodies is seen in rabies. Negri bodies are seen in rabies. Samoma bodies are seen in numerous conditions. Samoma bodies is present in meningioma. These are laminated calcified bodies. We will see this in papillary cancer of ovary, salivary gland, and papillary cancer of thyroid. So this is samoma bodies that you will see in papillary cancer of thyroid, meningiomas, papillary cancer of ovaries, and salivary gland. We call this also serous cystadenoma of ovaries. Two bodies, Schwann bodies and asteroid bodies. These Schwann bodies and asteroid bodies, these are seen in sarcoidosis. Schwann bodies and asteroid bodies, these are seen in sarcoidosis. Remember, first two alphabet in sarcoidosis are S and A. Schwann bodies, asteroid bodies are seen in sarcoidosis. Next body is ferruginous bodies. This ferruginous body is seen in asbestosis. Ferruginous body is seen in asbestosis. Always remember there are different particles of asbestos. Most dangerous fiber that is released in asbestos factory is amphibole. Krylla bodies are seen in asthma. Krylla bodies are seen in asthma. Dole bodies are seen due to sepsis. Heinz bodies also bite cells. These are seen in G6PD deficiency anemia. So what are these Heinz bodies? These Heinz bodies are precipitated hemoglobin. This is precipitated hemoglobin that is seen in G6PD deficiency anemia. Next is gamma antibodies. It is seen in splenic congestion. Splenic congestion, you will see gamma gandis bodies. Next body is torus body. This torus body, it is seen in yellow fever. Torus body is seen in yellow fever. Brassy bodies are seen in malaria. Brassy bodies are seen in malaria. Hymor bodies, or better known as body of Hymor, it is seen in mediastinal testis. It is seen in mediastinal testis. Mediastinal testis. Next is Garnier bodies. Garnier bodies are seen in vaccinia. So these are viral inclusion bodies. It is seen due to infection of vaccinia virus. Rokitansky bodies are seen in teratoma. Rokitansky bodies are seen in teratomas. Winkler bodies and Rose bodies, these are two bodies which we see in syphilis. Winkler bodies and Rose bodies are seen in syphilis. Zebra bodies are seen in metachromatic leukodystrophy. Cigar bodies are seen in sporotrichosis. In sporotrichosis, you will see cigar bodies. Next, we are having Pasteurian bodies. Pasteurian bodies are seen again in certain virus infection. You will see this Pasteurian bodies in variola or smallpox infection. It is seen in variola or smallpox infection. Bullinger bodies are seen in fowl pox infection. Bullinger bodies are seen in fowl pox infection. If you are noticing, second alphabet is O here, same it is O in fowl pox. Henderson Peterson bodies. This Henderson Peterson bodies, also known as HP bodies, these are seen in molluscum contagiosum. Then these are two bodies, that is Cowdery type A and Cowdery type B. Cowdery type A body is seen in herpes simplex virus. It is also seen in varicella zoster virus. Second type is Cowdery type B. This Cowdery type B is seen in polio and it is seen in adenovirus. So type A, herpes simplex virus, varicella zoster virus. Type B is seen in polio and adenovirus. Wharton-Finkelstein bodies or Wharton-Finkelstein cells, these are seen in measles. Howell-Jolly bodies, these are seen in a condition called asplenia. Any condition where a spleen is removed, you will see Howell-Jolly bodies. Any condition where you will see spleen is removed, it is called hovel jolly bodies. The last body which we are going to discuss is Papenheimer bodies. Papenheimer bodies, these are nothing, it is siderotic granules. Siderotic granules which you will see in different types of anemia, especially sideroblastic anemia. Sideroblastic anemia. Papenheimer bodies that you will see in sideroblastic anemia or siderosis. Thank you.